Hello friends, welcome to my new data structures and algorithms in Java tutorial series video. Friends, in this tutorial we will discuss the breadth first search of an undirected graph. So friends, breadth first search is nothing but a traversal or a searching technique which we apply to the graphs to visit each and every node of the graph. So here breadth first search is also known as level order traversal. So let's suppose we are given a graph of say 5 nodes where 0, 1, 2, 3 are connected by an edge and 4 is connected to 2 by an edge. So therefore, what do we mean by level order? So suppose if you are starting from 0, then this is at level 1. So this will be visited first, and then here you can see that from 0, 3 and 1 are connected. So these both nodes are at level 2. So after 0, 1 and 3 will be visited because they are at level 2, and then you can see that from 3 there is an edge to 2 and from 1 there is an edge to 2. So therefore the node 2 is at level 3. So after visiting 1 and 3, 2 will be visited because it is at level 3, and then here you can see node 4 is connected to 2. Now this is at level 4, so therefore 4 will be visited after 2. So 0 is at level 1, 1 and 3 are at level 2, 2 is at level 3 and 4 is at level 4. So using breadth first search technique, we can traverse the graph level by level. So friends, here is the algorithm for it. So friends, in this algorithm we usually use Q data structure. So this data structure is nothing but FIFO data structure, which means first in first out. So the element inserted into this data structure first will be first to be removed from the queue. So we are using queue because it will help us in traversing the nodes of a graph level by level. So friends, we apply the same algorithm while we are traversing the tree, but there is a slight catch in the graph because in the graphs it may contain a cycle, which you can see here. So therefore we need to keep the track of the nodes which are being visited. So we usually keep the track of the nodes into a Boolean array. So friend, let's see the working of this algorithm step by step. So we'll start with the value 0. So in this method we'll pass the source node as 0. So in first step what we do is we create a Boolean array whose size is equal to the number of vertices in the graph. So this vertices is nothing but the instance variable which we discussed in our previous tutorial. So here you can see in this graph there are 5 nodes. Therefore, we'll create a Boolean array by name visited having a size of 5. So it would look something like this. And as it is a Boolean array, so initially all the values inside this array is marked as false. And we have marked it false because initially we haven't visited any node of the graph. Moving ahead, we'll then create a queue data structure. Now this queue data structure will help us in traversing the nodes of a graph level by level. So it would look something like this. So here in our previous tutorial we also discussed how queue data structure works. So you can watch my those tutorial to get more in depth of how queue works. So it's simply a FIFO data structure where element inserted first will be first to be removed. Moving ahead. Now friend, as we are starting from 0, so we will mark the visited index as true, that we have visited this node. In the array we'll make it true, and here we'll mark it that we have visited this node. So friends, after we visit the node, we simply put that node into the queue. So as we have visited 0, we'll put the 0 into the queue. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead. So friend, as we want to traverse each and every node level by level, then we will apply a while loop and we'll check whether queue is empty or not. So currently you can see queue is not empty because there is one value inside the queue. So the condition in while block comes out to be true. So in the first step, we simply pull this element out of the queue, which is 0, and we'll assign it to the integer variable u. So it would look something like this, and it will be assigned to u. Moving ahead, we'll simply print this element on the console that it is visited. So 0 is printed on the console. So here in breakfast search, after visiting any particular node, we then go towards its adjacent nodes. So here you can see the node adjacent to 0 are 1 and 3. And in our previous tutorial, we saw the representation of a graph through adjacency list. So now we'll apply a for loop which will traverse the adjacent nodes of 0. So here if we look the adjacency list of graph, then the node adjacent to U would look something like this. That in the adjacency list, 0 is connected to 1 and 0 is connected to 3. So here 0 is connected to 1 and 0 is connected to 3. So now we'll traverse each and every adjacent nodes of 0. So we'll start with 1. So here V becomes 1. And the first step will check that whether 1 is already visited or not. So here in the array, we see that value of index 1 is false, therefore it's not visited. So in the if block, first we'll mark this node as visited by providing a value of true to index 1 of this boolean array. So it would look something like this. And here we'll mark it as visited. And after marking the node as visited, we'll simply put it into the queue. So we'll put 1 into the queue. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead, now V becomes 3. We check whether 3 is visited or not. So here in the boolean array, 3 is not visited. So we will first mark 3 as visited by making the value as true, that we have visited this node. And then we'll simply put 3 into the queue. Moving ahead, now as we have visited all the adjacent nodes of 0, therefore this for loop will terminate. And we will come back to our while loop and we'll check whether Q is empty or not. So here you can see Q is not empty. So we'll poll from the queue. So 1 will be polled out. So it would look something like this. And U will have value as 1. We'll print 1 on the console that we have visited it. So friends, now we will actually traverse the adjacent nodes of 1, which is nothing but 0 and 2, because they are connected to 1. And if we look the adjacency list of 1, then it would look something like this, that 1 is connected to 0 and 1 is connected to 2. So now in the for loop, we'll iterate over these two elements. So we'll start with 0. So V becomes 0. We will check whether 0 is visited or not. So here you can see 0 is already visited. Therefore, we'll simply skip this if block. And then now V becomes 2. We check whether 2 is visited or not. So here you can see 2 is not visited. So we will first mark the value at index 2 as true, that we have visited this node. And also we are marking it as we have visited this node. Moving ahead. And then we'll simply put the 2 into the queue. So it would look something like this. Moving ahead. Now friends, here you can see we have visited each and every adjacent nodes of 1. So therefore the for loop terminates. And then we'll come back to our while loop. We'll check whether Q is empty or not. So Q is not empty. We'll poll the first element from the queue, which is 3. So it would look something like this. And we'll assign its value to U. So U becomes 3. Moving ahead, we simply print 3 on the console that we have visited it. And friends, then we'll provide a for loop which will iterate over the adjacent nodes of 3. So here you can see the adjacent nodes of 3 are 0 and 2. So if we see the adjacency list of 3, then it would look something like this, that 3 is connected to 0 and 3 is connected to 2. So now we will visit the adjacent nodes of 3 and we'll start with 0. So V becomes 0. We check whether 0 is visited or not. So here you can see that 0 is visited. So we simply skip this if block. Now V becomes 2. And we check whether 2 is visited or not. So here you can see 2 is already visited. Therefore we simply skip the if block. So friends, there are no more adjacent nodes to 3. So therefore this for loop will terminate. We'll come back to our while block. We check whether Q is empty or not. So Q is not empty. We pull the first element from the queue, which is 2. So it would look something like this. And we'll assign it to integer variable u. So u becomes 2. And then we'll simply print the value of u on the console that we have visited it. So friends, now we will actually traverse the adjacent nodes of 2. So here you can see the nodes adjacent to 2 are 3, 1 and 4 because they all are connected by 2. So if we look the adjacency list of value 2, then it would look something like this, that 2 is connected to 3, 2 is connected to 1 and 2 is connected to 4. So therefore now we'll traverse each and every adjacent nodes of 2. So we'll start with 3. So V becomes 3. Moving ahead, we will check whether 3 is already visited or not. So here you can see in the visited array at index 3, the value is already true and it's already visited. Therefore, we simply skip this if block. Now V becomes 1. We know that we already visited 1. Therefore, we'll skip this if block. Now V becomes 4. And here we will check whether we have visited 4 or not. So we haven't visited 4 because the value at index 4 in the visited array is false. So in the first step, what we'll do, we'll mark this value as true that we are visiting it. Moving ahead, and then we'll simply offer 4 into the queue. So it would look something like this. So friends, now there are no more adjacent nodes left to be traversed. So this for loop will terminate. We'll again check whether queue is empty or not. So queue is not empty. We'll pull the first element out of the queue, which is 4. So it would look something like this. And we'll simply assign this value to u. So u becomes 4. We'll print this value on the console. And then we'll simply traverse the adjacent nodes to 4. So here in the diagram you can see the adjacent nodes to 4 is only 2. So if we see the adjacency list of index 4, so it would look something like this, that there is only one node which is adjacent to 4. So V becomes 2. We'll check whether 2 is visited or not. So here you can see 2 is already visited because the value at index 2 of the visited array is true. So we simply skip this if block. And here we already visited all the nodes adjacent to 4. So therefore this for loop will terminate. We'll check whether Q is empty or not. So currently you see Q is empty. therefore condition in while block comes out to be false. So friends, here you can see that we have visited each and every node of this graph using breadth first search algorithm, and you can see in the output that we have visited all the nodes level by level. So we started with level 1, which is 0, so we visited it. Then we went to level 2, where there were 1 and 3, so we visited those two nodes. Then we went to level 3, where the only node was 2, so we visited 2. And then we went to level 4, where the only node was 4, so we visited 4. So friend, this was a demonstration of the algorithm. Now let's go to Eclipse and see the working of this code.